Hello students, today we are going to study about the lizards and the snakes. As we know very well that lizards and snakes belongs to a class known as the reptilia of the chordates. Now we will be first dealing with the comparative account of the lizards and the snakes, and then we will be also discussing about the examples of both. First of all, lizards. The study of the lizard is called as the saurology, and the study of the snakes is called as the serpentology. First point, suborder Lacertalia means lizards belongs to a suborder known as the Lacertalia, while the snakes belongs to a suborder known as the Ophidia. Lizards have limbs, and also in them the girdles are developed, and they have four well-developed clawed pentadactyle limbs, means the limbs which are having five digits are called as the pentadactyle limbs, and they have claws on them, right? But here in the case of the snakes, the limbs are absent. Earlier they were having the limbs, but during the course of the evolution, what happened? The limbs degenerated. Only the python is an example of a snake which is having the vestigial hind limbs. Otherwise, the limbs are absent in the case of the snakes. In them, the sternum is present. In lizards, the sternum is present, while in the case of the snakes, the sternum is absent. The eyelids are movable in the lizards, while in the snakes, the eyelids are immovable. Nictitating membrane here is present, and nictitating membrane is entirely absent in the case of the snakes. Tympanum or the eardrum is present in the lizards, due to which they can hear. Tympanum or the eardrum is totally absent in the case of the snakes, and that's why they cannot hear. They just gain the vibrations from the earth. Both lungs are equally developed, means both the lungs in the lizards are of same size and shape, both are equally developed, but in the snakes, out of the two lungs, the left lung is less developed in comparison to the right lung. Autotomy found. Now what is autotomy? As we know very well that it is the feature of the lizards. Autotomy is the voluntary breakage of the tail to confuse the enemy at the time of the danger is called as the autotomy. Okay, and autotomy in the case of the snakes is absent. Snakes do not show autotomy. Now the next point is the molting or the ichthyosis. Molting or the ichthyosis is absent in the lizards, while the snakes are having molting or ichthyosis. Okay, now the question arises, what do we mean by molting or ichthyosis? Molting or ichthyosis means the removal of the epidermis of the skin periodically in single piece is called as the molting or the ichthyosis. Actually, during the process of the molting, the cornified cells of the skin are removed. So this was the comparative account of the lizards and the snakes. But we must also know the examples also about the lizards and the snake. So let's discuss about the examples of lizards and snakes. Now the very first example of the lizard is the Draco. This Draco is also called as the flying lizard. It is also called as the flying dragon. But you must remember that it never fly. Though the name is given flying dragon, but it's never fly. It just glides, and it glides with the help of a skin fold known as the patagium. Okay. Second one is Phrynosoma. Phrynosoma is also called as the horned toad. Why it is called as the horned toad? It is not a toad, it is a lizard. But then also it is called as the horned toad because it is having the horns at its apex, and hence it is called as the horned toad or Phrynosoma. Hemidactylus. This is the most common lizard which is actually found on the walls what we see. It is called as the house wall lizard. Okay. Next is the chameleon. Chameleon is the tree lizard. Basically it is found on the tree, and it shows camouflage. Camouflage is actually it makes its color similar to that of surrounding to protect it from the enemy, and this is called as the camouflage. Chameleon is also called as the tree lizard. Next one is the Haloderma. This is the poisonous lizard. Okay, this is the poisonous lizard. Okay, and it is called as the Gila monster. It is also called as the Gila monster. On its skin, certain beads like structures are found, and that's why it is also called as the beaded lizard, or it is also called as the Gila monster. Normally it doesn't bite, but when it bites the human, its bite is fatal and it causes death because of the poison. Varanus. Varanus is called as the monitor lizard. It is the largest living lizard. There is a species of the Varanus known as the Varanus comodensis. Varanus comodensis is having the weight of 100 kg and its length is 2.5 meters, and hence it is called as the largest living lizard. I am repeating once again, Varanus comodensis. Calotes. This is the most common lizard in India. It is also called as the Girgit, or it is also called as the garden lizard, and it also changes the color. Particularly, it changes the color of the neck region. Okay, it makes its color red or according to the surrounding medium. Euromastix. Euromastix is a spiny tailed lizard. It is also called as the Senda. It is also called as the oil lizard, because oil is isolated from this Euromastix, which is actually used to cure the muscular pains. Ophiosaurus. Now Ophiosaurus is limbless lizard. The point to be noted here, just now we have discussed about the comparative account of the lizards and the snake, and you have seen that the lizards were having the limbs, but this is the lizard which is a limbless lizard. Okay, Ophiosaurus. And it is also called as a glass snake. Why glass snake? Because it shows autotomy. It leaves its tail, or it breaks its tail when seized. Okay, not only this, Barracuda. It is also a limbless lizard which is found in the South India. Ambilirhynchus. This Ambilirhynchus is found at the Galapagos Island, very famous island related to the Darwin. So the Ambilirhynchus is found on the Galapagos Island. And Moloch, it is a lizard which is found in the deserts of the Australia. Okay, so these are the main examples of the lizards. Now coming to the snakes. Okay, now snakes, I have separated the examples of the poisonous snake as well as the non-poisonous snake for the sakeness of, or we can say for your easiness, I have made a column of the poisonous snake and the non-poisonous snake. Now first one is Naza Naza. It is called as the cobra. Okay, and it is the very much poisonous snake. Viper Rasail. Viper Rasail. It is also a deadly poisonous snake. Bungerus, which is also called as the common crate. Okay, Hydrophis, it is the sea snake. Normally the snakes found in water are non-poisonous, but this is a sea snake which is poisonous. Crotalus. Crotalus is also called as the rattlesnake. Why it is called as a rattlesnake? Because it produces a specific sound known as rat-a-rat. Right? Rat-a-rat. And that's why it is called as the rattlesnake. Naza Hanha. It is called as the king cobra. See here, Naza Naza is the cobra, and Naza Hanha is the king cobra. Anhydrina. Anhydrina is also a sea snake. So you have studied Hydrophis, which was also a sea snake, and Anhydrina is also a sea snake. And all the poisonous snakes, what about the poisonous snake is that snake poison is a mixture of the enzyme. Snake poison is a mixture of the enzyme. It is a very good type of the digestive juice, but when it mixes with the blood, then it acts as a poison. Otherwise, the snake venom is not a venom. It is a mixture of enzyme, and it acts as a good digestive juice. Okay. Now these are some examples of non-poisonous snake. Teflops. Teflops is also called as a blind snake. Python molurus. This Python molurus is commonly called as the ajgar. Okay, or commonly called as the python. I have written one more species of the python here, that is known as the Python reticularis. Or Python reticulatus. It is the largest species of the python found in the Southeast Asia, and its length is approximate 10 meters. Okay, Tias muscasus. Okay, the next one is the Dendrophis, also known as the tree snake or the arboreal snake. Eryx johnii. Its complete name is Eryx johnii. It is called as the sand boa, also called as the double-headed snake. But a double-headed snake, it is called as double-headed snake, but it is not having two heads. Okay, its tail is little bit folded, just like the head, and that's why it is called as a double-headed snake. Otherwise, it is not having two heads. Okay, Dryophis is also called as the whip snake. So, dear student, this was the video based on the lizards and the snake. Okay, the comparative account along with the examples. Keep watching my videos. Thank you.